Today I'm going to teach you Tinkercad in 10 minutes, so let's get cracking. Step one, of course, is to visit Tinkercad.com. And then I always choose sign in with Google. This is our homepage. This is what a design looks like. Today, though, we are going to create a brand new 3D design. I like to start by naming our projects. We do that by clicking right up here. I'm going to choose the name House 2025. That is the start of our project. I'm just going to show you real quickly. If we click back to the Tinkercad dashboard, it saves automatically. Of course, these are our other projects. To get back into the one that we just created, we simply hit Tinker this. In Tinkercad, we build with basic shapes. You can see a long list of them here. There are many more that you can work with. We'll highlight those later. Right now, I simply want you to grab the red cube and bring it out on what is called the work plane. This is where our projects are built. When you click on this shape, you can change the numbers by typing, but you can also use the black handles to stretch it to whatever size you want. I'm going to actually have you type the numbers. So when we click this and click the handle, we can put a number like 80 in this box, and I'm going to click this box and put 50, and then I want to make sure the height is 35 and press enter. This will be the beginning of our fun house. I also want to line it up with the work plane. Check this out. We're going to use the ruler, and I want you to simply bring the ruler in and match it to one of these grid lines. If you miss, you can drag it to the next spot. Once you get it to where you want, click on the body of our house, and we're going to find these green numbers and see where it says negative 5. Make that 0. And whatever this measurement is, that's telling us the distance it is from the point. So it's 11 millimeters. We're going to click that and make it 0. So now it has snapped right to that grid line. I'm going to hit dismiss to get rid of the ruler. Once again, it is always right here, or you can press the letter R to bring it back. Just a quick reminder that if you ever feel the videos are going too fast, you can always click right here on playback speed and pick the speed that's best for you. I'm going to quickly hollow this out so it's walls. Do that by clicking on our original box and doing Ctrl D or duplicate. Notice it'll show you the shortcuts if you highlight them. I'm going to drag it away. I'm going to make it a hole. I'm going to click on its measurements, and where it was 50, we're going to make it 46. So I took away 2 from every side. Same thing over here. I'm going to make this 76 and press enter. I'm going to make it taller just so it's easier to grab. And now I'm going to get it close to our shape. Select those two, choose L for align, click the red one to make it the boss. And we want it to be the middle of these three and the middle of these three. And of course, we want the bottom on the vertical plane. If we grab those two and hit the group button or Control G, bingo, our house has walls. All right, let's quickly add a roof. We're going to land the green roof right on this edge using what's called cruising. If you grab this shape right here, it would land on the work plane. This would land on the side of the house. And when you get right there, bingo, it lands where you want the roof to be. I'm going to use the black handle to stretch this out. Notice the white handle goes two directions at a time, so it's a little trickier. Using the black handles is just a little bit easier when you're getting used to Tinkercad. I'm going to change the height. Let's look at this from a corner on the view cube. And bingo, find the height we want for our roof. I'll let you pick the numbers that you think are cool. Of course, we want that aligned, so let's select it again. Choose L for align. And let's choose center, and that one already is center, and of course it stays up top. Let's pick a different color for our roof. I'm going to pick a brown roof. Let's also pick a different color for the house part. I'm going to go to custom for this one. I'm going to go into the blues and just find a color I think is cool. You can do the same. Another cool tool is T for transparent. Let's quickly add a door to our house. Simply bring out the whole cube, set it on the work plane. Let's take the handles and shrink it down. Notice I'm getting it down to 10 by 12. I do not care about how thick this is. It only needs to go through at least 2. And then I'm going to change this to 15. Of course, we could have typed those numbers as well. Once we've got it the way we want, we can move it into the house, but we can also use the arrow keys to nudge it into the house. Once we're sure that it's cutting through, we can do Control G to group, If you don't like that alignment, check this out. We can double click so that we're editing. That's what this pink line means. Now I'm going to select the two, choose L for align, click on the house to make it the boss, and now my door is centered. If I wanted to make it a little taller, I can double click again, and I can click on this, and instead of 15, I could make it 17, 18, whatever I wanted to get the exact design I want. Let's quickly add a window. We're going to use a special trick called shift squeeze. Notice when we bring this out, it's 20 by 20. If we hold down shift and drag the handle to Crazyville, it stretches the same amount in every direction. If we type the number 10 and press enter, it snaps to a very cool size for a window. We can drag it into place, and then I'm going to do Ctrl Up Arrow to raise it to the height I want. Now I want two of those windows, so I'm going to do Ctrl D to duplicate, and we're going to do Shift Nudge to move it to the other side. Once again, you pick the alignment that you like, and then we're going to group those to cut them out. Now the fewer groupings you have, the better, so check it out. We're going to ungroup the house, and then select those and make it one group by grouping when all four are selected. Let's hit T to shut off transparency and check out a solid version of our house. Let's quickly fill in the door and those windows. We're going to do a trick here. We're going to do Ctrl D. So there are two. I'm going to nudge this one out with the arrow keys a few clicks, just so we can tell which is which. We're going to click on it, and we are going to ungroup it. We no longer need the big walls. All we want are the windows and the door. We're going to take each of these, and we're going to match them to our wall size. Simply click the side measurement and make them all two. Of course, we want them all to be solids, so let's just pick a solid color. And then I'm going to pick a color for my door. I'm going to do a tan brown. And then for the windows, I'm going to shift select, and I'm going to make them the light blue and hit T for transparent. Notice they now look like glass. I'm going to grab all of those parts. I'll look at this from a bit of a corner. L for align, and we want them to match the front of the house. Bingo, you have now got a house with doors and windows. How cool is that? Our 10 minutes is almost up, but I've got to show you the brand new sketch tool. I want you to look at the world from an angle. Notice this is a 20 by 20 grid. So is the sketch tool. Bring it out and make sure you line it up with one of those grids. Notice this lines up with the center. We're going to use that for our project. Move out to the first centimeter here, and we want to go up 2 millimeters. And then I want you to take the next one, go to the center, and I want you to go up 4 millimeters. Of course, we want to go back down to that 2 millimeter spot, 2 millimeter spot, 2 millimeter spot, and just build this little straight roof like this. Notice we just quickly drew that with straight lines. Now, what's awesome is we can double click on that, and you could choose all sorts of different curves. But for today, I just want you to see if you double click, it automatically becomes rounded. How cool is that? If we hit finish sketch, we're going to take this and put it as an awning. I want you to put it there using C for cruise, grab the dot, and set it on your house. I want to stretch it a little longer. We can do that with the black handles. I also want to line it up, so we are going to shift select, choose L for align, click on the main house, which is blue, and choose center. Let's stretch it out a little further. I'm going to pick that same color. And now we could make a post with a cylinder, but check out this trick. If you want a perfect post, once again, set it in a 20 by 20 grid and make a diamond 1 millimeter by each corner. When you connect it, of course, straight lines, but if you double click and edit and double click again, it is perfectly round. How cool is that? Of course, now use the skills you've learned so far to place it, stretch it, duplicate it, and match the color to your design. There you have it. Tinkercad in 10 minutes. Of course, there's tons more to learn. Make sure you check the cards up above for all sorts of other tutorials on my channel. I do, of course, want to invite you to become a member of the channel and, of course, give my current members a shout out. Of course, I also want to thank everybody that is a Patreon member. You can, of course, learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button, share a video, add a comment down below, or hit subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.